Hi everyone! Today I'm going to show you how to create a web swinging animation with Blender, like this one from one of my recent videos. Be aware that this is not a complete beginner's tutorial. You should know at least the very basics of Blender and how to use it to animate a scene. Alright, let's get started! First you need a minifigure. I'm using this Miles Morales Spider-Man from Mechabricks. I rigged it with the free Epic Fig Rig add-on. For the sake of this tutorial, I'm creating a very basic city scene, just two cubes to represent the buildings. Next I add in a curve, which will be the path that he swings along. Of course you don't necessarily need it, you could also animate the path completely by hand, but for the sake of this tutorial I'm going with the curve. That's what I did in my original animation as well. Once you're happy with your curve, select the rig, go to pose mode and select the main controller. Then add a follow path bone constraint. Pick the curve as the target. Click Follow Curve and Animate Path. Also negative Y as the forward axis and X as the up axis. And now you can see that the minifig is following the curve. When you want to change the speed, select the curve, make sure you're in object mode and go to the curve options. Under path animation you can change the number of frames that it should take to move along the path. This looks a bit sharp, so I decided to flatten the curves a little bit. But yeah, I'm not gonna make a perfect animation here, just good enough to show you the basics. Also make sure to look at your curve from every angle. Here you can see that it looked good from the side, but from the top you can see that it was all over the place. And if your Spider-Man is tilted to the side like mine here, just select the curve, go to edit mode and right here you can adjust the tilt so that he points straight up. Okay, this looks good. Now I fast forward while I'm creating a very basic swing animation, mostly to get his hands in the right position so we can add the webs to them. Alright, it's finally time to add the webs. I'm using a free Geometry Nodes based web model from the Blender Bricks Discord server. Link in the description. It's the first pinned message in the Blender general topic. Download it and append it to your scene. This is how it looks. What I do next is select the hand, not the bone in the rig, but the real model of the hand. Press Shift S and cursor to active. That way we don't have to eyeball where the web should go. Just select the curve, not the curve we used for the path, but the curve from the web. Oh, and you can hide these elements by the way. Okay, now back to edit mode. Click first vertex point. Shift S, selection to cursor. Keep offset. And now the web is precisely where the hand is. Now we need to create a hook. So press Ctrl H, hook to new object. This created a new empty. Select it, go to object mode. If you like to, you can scale it up and change how it looks. Alright, now with the empty still selected, add a child of constraint. And as target pick the hand part. In case your empty moved to somewhere else, just press set inverse and it should come back. To avoid the web and the hand to clip, you can move the web a little bit. At the end of the video, I'll show you another way to do it. Alright, we are halfway done. The web now moves with the hand, at least one side of it. For the other side, we just do the same thing again. Shift right click to move the cursor. Select the curve, not that one, the other curve. Go to edit mode. Select the other end of the web. Shift S, selection to cursor. Keep offset. I prefer to make the bezier smaller, because I feel like the web should hang more in a straight line where it connects to the building. Add another hook with Ctrl H, resize U empty if you want to. And there we go. So, now how do we animate the web shooting out from his hand? Well, just by doing exactly that. Select the hook and add keyframes for position and rotation. Then move a couple of frames back and move it closer to the hand. Don't forget to look at it from multiple angles, and simply adjust it to your liking. When you feel like the web curves too much, select the curve and in edit mode reduce the size of the handles. Okay, nice. Now he needs to let go of the web. How do we do that? Move forward in time and find the right moment. Select the empty, and animate the influence of the child of constraint. Keyframe here with I, move one frame forward and change the value to 0. The web now moves back where it started, but that's fine. We just move it back with the empty. So move one frame back to when the web is still attached. Set a keyframe for position and rotation. And to better find the right position, we can move the cursor to the hand like we did before. Then move forward one frame and move the empty to the cursor. Compare it with the previous frame. Adjust the rotation. And there you go. Now, if you like to, you can animate a little wiggle to the hanging web. Alright, now we need to deal with the beginning of the scene, because as you can see here, the web is visible even before we want to see it. And for that, simply select both empties, move to the frame where you want the web to start, add keyframes for position, move one frame back and move the empties below your scene or anywhere where they're not visible to the camera. And better, also animate the influence of the child of constraint so the web doesn't pop back up like here. Nice. So how do we add another web? Move to the point where the second should appear. Move the cursor to the hand like we did before. Then select the web curve, go to edit mode. And with this pencil you can draw a new web. I like to keep mine very short so I get just 2 points. For other scenes more points may be useful, but for web swinging and working with hooks, 2 points is the way to go. Well, and then you just repeat everything we just did, but with the new web. Congratulations! Now you can animate your Spider-Man web swinging scene with Blender. I have one more thing than I teased earlier in the video, because I never liked how this piece here doesn't really connect to the hand. You just can't really adjust its rotation. If you want to fix that, we have to do a little adjustment in the geometry node. Don't be afraid, it's really simple. First, open a new window and go to the geometry node editor. Then select this plane object. This is where the magic happens. This might look confusing, but we just have to tweak two little things. First, go to this node here and change the start size to 0. This removes the 1x1 piece at the beginning of the web. But now we have this other piece that we don't want either. To fix this, press Shift A and search for the offset point in curved node. Change the offset to -1. And plug the offset to the selection socket of this node. And voila, this is what we wanted. Now we can use the original piece, cylinder 001, as the starting piece. Duplicate it and move the duplicate to the hand. You'll notice that it's very small, so just scale it up and move and rotate it to fit nicely on the hand. Add a child of constraint and pick the hand as the target. Ideally, you do this at the beginning of your animation. And then you would select the empty with the hook and not make that a child of the hand, but a child of this new piece. That way, the empty will always stay connected with the starting piece. I hope this wasn't too confusing. This is my first tutorial. If you have any question, feel free to ask them in the comments. Have a nice day and good luck with your animation. Bye!